Olamide says, just be thankful for your position because there are some people that are happier with less. Yeah, that's pretty straightforward and quite strong.
Stating the obvious.
I think the only thing I would say is that there's a difference between being complacent and being content. I'll have to put those two things. It's good to be content where you are no matter what. Like, even when I'm in phases in my life that I know, this has to be temporary, I still have to try and strive for contentment in that situation, because that's really the only time I could be happy in the present. But I don't want to then get complacent in that position because I'm content. So I think that's the only thing that I would want to add.
Yes,
that's the only thing I want to add to that.
Obviously, there are people with less. You feel like yours is the worst, but when you look at other people, you find out that you're actually very privileged to even be where you are. So I think one thing that should be constant with all of us is always be thankful, be grateful for what you have. Be always look back and reflect on how far you've come, and that way, that's the only way to move forward, if you ask me.
And also acknowledge your privileges, no matter how small you think they are, how big. It is a big deal for some people. When I read the tweet, it was self-explanatory, but I felt it's also nice for people to read it and take a moment to think about it, because this period has actually made a lot of people... Sorry.
Is that Rona?
God forbid.
Has made a lot of people focus more on the negatives than the positives. And for some, a good number of people have as well tried to count their blessings to stay happy. But I think happiness is a decision, regardless whether there's food on your table or you now have to do 101 or 010. How do they call it? So when you know you have breakfast,
or when you ration your food, you have breakfast, you miss lunch, you have dinner. 101. Okay. What about 001?
It happens.
Sometimes it happens because of business. Yeah, no time. Yeah. I also say that isn't it like gratitude for me is something I would like to explore. I don't think I do it very deliberately. Like, I want to be grateful today, because every time I watch movies about or documentaries about people who either have a very near-death experience or like fought cancer or something, they don't talk about anything else but gratitude. Like, be happy for what you have. Be happy for what you have. And I think because we're so fast age, like you just said, where we even do the 001 because we can't like take a minute to like sit down. It's so easy to like forget the things that are important. I think Corona period has also helped bring that gratitude spirit back up globally. Now, like, what am I thankful for? Because a lot of things have been stripped away, and things that I didn't even think were something I should be grateful for that I'm now grateful for now.